世界的尽头。灾难的巅峰，战场上的勇士，耶稣快再来，你预备好了吗？预备迎接末世。
A special welcome to all Angel TV viewers who are watching this program.
我们欢迎所有收看安琪 TV 的弟兄姐妹和观众朋友们。
This program is called Prepared to Meet the End Times.
这个节目是预备迎接末世。
Its purpose is to make us aware and to prepare for the end times.
目的是让我们能够对将要发生的事情有所警觉。
Today's topic is marriage for men.
今天的题目是有关男士的婚姻课题。
I have taken these studies from various resources and also included my own personal experience.
我研究过不同的资料来源，也包括了自己的个人的经历。
To bring these instructions for men to reach a peak of happiness and wonderful fulfillment in their relationship with their spouse.
为了要帮助男士们与他们的配偶能够建立快乐并且美好的婚姻生活。
First, we're going to see 10 ways how husbands damage the spirit of their marriage.
首先我们要看到丈夫破坏婚姻的十种方式。
But before we go on, I want to encourage the women watching this program.
但是在我们继续之前，我要鼓励收看这节目的女士们
，Get your husbands to watch this program.
也邀请你的丈夫一起的来收看这个节目。
It will be beneficial for both of you in your marriage.
这将会对你们的婚姻，对你们两位都会有很大的帮助。
When the spirit of a wife is wounded, the spirit of the marriage is damaged.
当一个妻子的心灵受损的时候，这个婚姻也受到了破坏。
A damaged spirit will in turn affect the psychological and physical aspect of the marriage.
一个受伤的心灵将会为婚姻带来心理的和甚至生理的破坏。
If the husband attempts to restore the psychological,or physical aspect of the marriage.
如果一个丈夫想要恢复婚姻的生理和心理这两方面的状况的话，
Before restoring the spirit of the marriage, he will only produce deeper wounds and ultimately fail.
在恢复这个婚姻之前，他很可能他会造成更深的伤害，而最终导致失败。
Let us turn to the Epistle of 1 Peter chapter 3 verse 7.
让我们翻开彼得前书第三章第七节。
Husbands, likewise, dwell with them with understanding, giving honor to the wife, as to the weaker vessel, and as being heirs together of the grace of life, that your prayers may not be hindered.
你们做丈夫的也要按情理和妻子同住，因他比你软弱，与你一同承受生命之恩的，所以要敬重他，这样便叫你们的祷告没有阻碍。
As each offense is sowed, there is a precise and predictable reaping of destruction in marriage harmony.
当一个破坏性的举动或者言语说出来的时候呢，将会带来一个很明确的而且是可以预知的这种破坏性来产生在婚姻的和谐当中。
Galatians chapter 6 verse 7 it says, Do not be deceived, God is not mocked, for whatever a man sows, that he will also reap.
加拉太书第六章第七节说，不要自欺，神是轻慢不得的，人种的是什么，收的也是什么。
Let us sow some good seeds.
让我们来撒好种。
Failing to love, honor, and cherish your wife more than every other woman, job, or hobby in your life.
没有疼爱、尊荣、珍惜你的妻子超过其他的女人，或者的在工作和兴趣上面更看重超过自己的妻子。
A wife knows when her husband delights to be with some other women.
一个妻子会知道她的丈夫喜欢其他的女人胜于她。
She knows when her husband's job or hobby means more to him than she does.
妻子也会知道丈夫看重她的工作和兴趣胜过看重她。
A husband's failure to give his wife first place among people is a contradictory to God's design of marriage.
一个丈夫如果不能够看重自己的妻子胜于其他的人和事的话，这是违反神的诫命的，违反神对婚姻的设计的。
1 Corinthians chapter 7 verse 32 and 33.
哥林多前书第七章三十二到三十三节。
But I want you to be without care. He who is unmarried cares for the things of the Lord, how he may please the Lord. But he who is married cares about the things of this world, how he may please his wife.
我愿你们无所挂虑，没有娶妻的，是为主的事挂虑，想怎么样叫主喜悦；娶了妻的，是为世上的事挂虑，想怎么样叫妻子喜悦。
When a husband is preoccupied with other people, with possessions or activities, his wife doubts his love and becomes insecure.
当一个丈夫更看重其他的人、他的产业，甚至其他的活动的时候，他的妻子就会怀疑丈夫对她的爱，而且就会变成没有安全感。
Men,How do you make your wife's first place?
做丈夫的，你要如何让你的妻子成为你的第一位呢？
On the practical side, establish a weekly or a monthly night out first.
从实际的角度来说，首先要至少分别每周或者每个月要有一个在一起的夜晚。
Make surprise appointments for lunch.
为她办一个意外的午餐约会。
Call her occasionally during your breaks at work.
在你工作的暇余之间，给她意外的电话。
Help with the washing of the dishes.
帮助她洗碗盘。
Be attentive to your wife and your children whenever you return home.
每当你回到家的时候，先把你的注意力放在你的妻子和孩子身上。
Meet her deepest needs by providing time for intimate conversation.
花时间跟她在一起做深度的交流，了解她内心深处的需要。
Provide good manners with your wife.
善待你的妻子，对她有礼貌。
The next point, neglecting to provide spiritual leadership.
第二点，忽略提供属灵的领导。
True spiritual leadership is translated into meeting a wife's basic needs.
一个真的属灵领导是会来满足妻子的基本需要的。
A wife wants her husband to have open communication with God in prayer.
一个妻子期待跟她的丈夫能够一起的在神的面前有开放的交流。
And a clear understanding of God's word through reading, studying, memorizing, and meditation.
而且能够期望从丈夫那里听到对神话语的理解。研读甚至背诵跟默想神的话。
Spiritual leadership is determined not by where a husband is in his Christian walk, but but the direction he is going.
一个属灵的领导，不是看这个丈夫是不是一个基督徒，过一个基督徒的生活，而是在于丈夫是否能够给予他一个属灵的方向的领导。
Men, God wants us to be in a continual attitude of seeking Him.
做丈夫的，神要我们有一个持续寻求他的态度。
This attitude is what He has promised to reward in us, as He did with King Uzziah.
这样的态度是神对乌西亚王的要求，也是同样的对我们做丈夫的要求。
Let us turn to the book of 2 Chronicles, chapter 26, verse 5.
让我们翻开历代志下第26章第5节。
He sought God in the days of Zechariah, who had understanding in the visions of God. And as long as he sought the Lord, God made him prosper.
通晓神的默示，撒加利亚在世的时候，乌西亚定义寻求神，他寻求耶和华，神就使他亨通。
The most important way to demonstrate spiritual leadership is to stand up for spiritual convictions.
一个最重要的属灵领导的示范，就是要把对圣经的信念活出来。
Even when it costs us to do so.
尽管要遵行对圣经的信念需要付代价，也要在所不惜。
Men refuse to compromise God's standard in personal living, marriage relationship, and business dealings.
做丈夫的要拒绝把神的标准妥协，在个人的生活当中，在婚姻的关系里头，甚至在商业的场合当中。
When a husband shows lack of interest in being a spiritual leader,
当一个做丈夫的显出他对于属灵的领导没有兴趣的时候，
His wife feels insecure and unable to place her confidence in him.
他的妻子就会觉得没有安全感，而且不能够全心的来相信他。
Number three, announcing changes and moves without giving your wife adequate time to mentally prepare herself.
在妻子没有足够的时间做好预备来面对这个突然的改变的时候，
A wife's world is her home and family.
对于妻子来说，家庭就是她的全部，她的世界。
She finds her security and fulfillment in wisely managing them.
当一个妻子在家里面有智慧的来掌管家里的杂事的时候，她感觉到有安全感，而且有成就感。
If a sudden move is required, a wife needs to mentally move before she physically moves.
做妻子的需要在心理上面先做好预备来面对任何的变动。
She needs to picture in her mind all the things that will be necessary in order to maintain the management of her priorities.
她必须在思想上面先预知预估面对这些变动所会要带来的这些次序的安排，这是做女人在心理上面的需要。
A wife also needs to be part of such decisions as changing employment, finding a new home, rearranging the furniture, remodeling the home, and taking a vacation.
一个做妻子的也需要能够参与在这些变化的决策当中，比如说变换工作，或者找一个新的房子，或者重整家里面的 这些摆设，还有家里面的维修，还甚至于出去外面郊游度假。
When a husband does not give his wife sufficient time to rearrange her mental and emotional frame of reference for change, she becomes insecure, apprehensive, and bitter.
当一个丈夫没有提供足够的时间让妻子在心里面先做好预备来面对这些改变的话，他会变成一个没有安全感，甚至变成有具有攻击性，或者甚至有苦读。
The next point is making unfavorable comparisons with other women.
接下来就是把妻子跟别的女人做不正确的或者不恰当的比较。
Wives are extremely alert and sensitive to what their husbands look at.
做妻子的会很敏感于她的丈夫如何的看待她。
Many wives also have problems with self-acceptance.
很多做妻子的，他们都有自我接纳的困难。
Most husbands are totally oblivious to the inward part that comes to a wife when she notices her husband staring at another woman.
很多做丈夫的会忽视妻子的感受，当做丈夫的把眼目注视在别的女人身上的时候。
God has many warnings and admonitions to men to control their eyes.
神很多时候警告做丈夫的要好好的管理自己的眼目。
When men look lustfully at other women or sensual magazines,
当男人带着有色的眼光看待其他的女人或者一些色情的刊物的时候，
They are saying to their wives, physical attraction is more important to me than inward character.
他们其实就是对妻子发出一些信息，就是说这个身体的吸引力比内在的品格的吸引力来得更大。
And that other women please me more than you do.
而其他的女人对我的吸引力比你来得更重。
Men, it's not about pleasing you, but about pleasing your wife.
做丈夫的，我们要注意到，不是要讨你自己的喜欢，重要的是讨你的妻子、你的配偶的喜欢。
Let's turn to the book of Proverbs, chapter 4, verse 23.
让我们翻开箴言书第四章二十三节。
Keep your hearts with all diligence, for out of it springs the issues of life. Let your eyes look straight ahead, and your eyelids look right before you.
你要保守你心胜过保守一切，因为一生的果效是由心发出。
When a husband admires the appearance or abilities of other women,
当一个男人欣赏另外的女人的容貌或者她的能力的时候，
His wife is deeply hurt, becomes jealous, and begins to reject herself.
她的妻子将会受到很深的伤害，而且会产生嫉妒的心，而开始弃绝自己。
The fifth point, lacking discipline to control anger and impure habits.
第五点，就是缺乏自制的能力，来控制自己的怒气和不健康的习惯。
A man who cannot control his temper is as defenseless as a city with the walls broken down.
人不制服自己的心，好像毁坏的城邑没有墙垣。
Anger damages the spirit of a marriage and relationship with the children.
怒气会破坏了这个婚姻的关系，还有跟儿女们的关系。
Anger is very often the result of a husband's frustration at his wife for not understanding what he tries to explain to her.
经常怒气都是发生于这个丈夫的心中感觉到沮丧，或者认为妻子对他的意思没有充分的去理解的时候，这个怒气就产生了。
Effective communication, however, involves much more than words.
为了要达到有效的沟通，不只是注重在话语上的沟通而已。
Unless taken care of, the husband's frustration will result in bitterness for the wife.
除非丈夫能够很谨慎的处理，要不然丈夫的怒气会挑起妻子的苦毒。
Let's turn to the book of Colossians chapter 3 verse 19 and I read, Husbands, love your wife and do not be bitter towards them.
哥罗西书第三章十九节，你们做丈夫的要爱你们的妻子，不可苦待他们。
Most of the anger on the part of the husband and the father is the byproduct of moral impurity in his life.
大部分做丈夫或者做父亲的，他们的怒气之所以产生，主要的原因大部分是因为他们自己的道德的不纯洁所带来的果效。
If a man sows immorality in his life, he will reap emptiness and his anger will destroy the people it touches.
如果一个男人在他的生命当中有不道德的这种行为的话，他将会收获空虚和他的这个愤怒会破坏他的人际关系。
I want to read Proverbs 22 verse 8 and it says, He who sows iniquity will reap sorrow, and the rod of his anger will fail.
箴言书第二十二章第八节，撒罪孽的必收灾祸，他逞怒的杖也必废掉。
Not only must husbands learn to control his own sexual drives, but he must also know when it is inappropriate or medically unwise to have physical intercourse with his wife.
一个做丈夫的，他不只是要懂得如何控制自己的情欲，而且他也必须要知道，在这个和什么时候是合适或者不合适与妻子行房的这个时机。
During these times of abstinence, wives want their husbands to continue to show them love in other ways.
在禁戒情欲或者禁戒行房的这段期间，做妻子的希望他们的丈夫能够持续的用别的方式来显出对妻子的爱。
I want to close this message now by leading you into a prayer. Can you please close your eyes?
在我们结束今天的节目之前，我想带大家做一个祷告，请大家闭上眼睛。
Father, in the name of Jesus, I pray a special favor to all the men who are watching this program.
天父，我奉耶稣基督的名要为所有收看这节目的男士们来做祷告。
Provide your grace for them to receive this word and to act upon it. In Jesus' name I pray.
求你施恩，让他们能够把今天所听到的信息能够行在他们的生活当中。愿你恩待保守他们，奉耶稣基督的名。
We look forward to seeing you again in the next session. God bless you all. Amen.
我们期待下周同样的时间跟你们相会，愿神赐福于你们，阿门。